Brothers and sisters, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers at the Infant Jesus Shrine, Mangalore. I warmly welcome you to Carmel Preran, Reflection on the Day's Gospel. It's the Friday of the 34th week in Ordinary Time. The Holy Gospel according to Luke, chapter 21, verses 29 to 33. Jesus told his disciples a parable. Consider the fig tree and all the other trees. When their buds burst open, you see for yourselves and know that summer is now near. In the same way, when you see these things happening, know that the kingdom of God is near. Amen, I say to you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friends, it's time to close the liturgical year as Advent is now approaching. Next Sunday, we begin the first Sunday of Advent. When we read of the end of the world, there is another phase of interpretation which is not much external but internal. And as we come to the end of the liturgical year, the readings, both the first and the gospel, speak about the end of the world. And there are characters or words like dragon, devil, evil, death, etc. These words or characters do exist in each and every individual in different forms. In the book of Revelation, you find book of Daniel, such characters. And that is what we read in the first reading these days. So they do exist in each and every individual in different forms. It could be evil inclinations, bad habits, nasty thoughts, wrong actions, etc. When a person begins to enter into a faith-filled life and deepens his or her faith through prayer, reflection on the scriptures and meditation, a person begins to enter into the unknown. Through prayer, one gets to face all these characters inside, and there might emerge a great battle within. Battle with our bad habits, inclinations, nasty thoughts, wrong actions. The person might have an experience of an angel coming from heaven with an enormous chain to bind all these evil tendencies. It could mean that a person is on the mode of change in attitude, change in behavior, change in the human nature itself. Consequently, a person grows calm and peaceful anger and hatred, jealousy and revenge, non-forgiveness, rage and all sinfulness itself is chained. As a result of the fight. But this may be short-lived. If there is any moment of laxity or willful sinfulness, it may be short-lived because there is negligence, there is no continuity, there is willful sinfulness. Hence, the binding is never permanent. We always run the risk of being attacked by our own inclinations at any time. On the other hand, when a life of faith is nourished by prayer and meditation, one will have the grace to see the earth and sky of sin vanishing and the dawn of a new heaven and earth filled with the presence of God. Eventually, we will gain untold knowledge of the realities of life here and of life beyond matter. So it's time, my dear friends, it's time. Let us look at our own signs. If we are approaching the end of evil in us or still persisting in it. Let us pray. Dear Lord, bind our sinfulness so that we can experience the joy of your abiding presence. Amen. Brothers and sisters, today is 1st of December. And today the world marks as World AIDS Day. It is an opportunity for people worldwide and especially for us Catholics to unite in the fight against HIV, to continue to show support for people living with HIV and to commemorate those who have died from an AIDS-related illness. It was founded in 1988. So for a moment, let's keep silence. Let's remember all those people who have died of AIDS. Let's remember all those people who are suffering at the present due to AIDS and related illnesses. There are also many people who are taking care of them. Let's pray for them. The doctors and the nurses who are treating them. The homes where they are treated. Let's remember them all for a moment. God of promise. Today we are mindful of our sisters and brothers suffering with HIV and AIDS. We ask your healing presence on millions of people living with the disease today, particularly the children who are infected or who have been orphaned by the disease. Make of us a safe heaven for those who are abandoned, discriminated against and rejected on account of their illness. Inspire us to speak out for a just distribution of health care and medical aid in this country and for generosity in sharing our resources with those struggling under the weight of this epidemic overseas. As we begin our Advent celebration of waiting in hope for the birth of your Son, let us remember those across the world who wait in hope for a cure. Amen. Brothers and sisters, have a great day. Continue to pray for the AIDS affected. May Almighty God bless you. The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest. My number is 94812-63229. See you tomorrow. Thank you.